Hello, people. This is my new hardcore series. Core. Season 1. As soon as I press this button, my whole life will change. These few rudimentary resources will change my life. Reset my keys. There we go. I don't see a planes. This is kind of a bad spot. I was hoping I would spawn in like a whole of planes biome, but no, this isn't bad. I'll take it. It's better than that. Oh no. This is a birch biome. I died in a tall birch biome. I died in one of my hardcore worlds. I was doing so good. I was trying to mine. I was just playing this one night, and I accidentally. Actually, never mind. I like this spawn. It's not too bad. There's a blacksmith. I'll take it. There's at least a blacksmith. I'll take it. Oh, and there's a plane spawn, right? Let's go. Blacksmith. Yes. Oh no. I'm not gonna get that iron golem just yet. There's a blacksmith. But this is a pretty big village. Holy crap. It's a huge village.
Strike a lightning rod with the pride and it doesn't. sure if these would fill when I'm not in the church because they're in small, but they didn't. It's still a good chance to check on my shulker farm and see how it's doing. 7 shulker shells at the moment, that's pretty good. It's very nicely working away for me. And that means that getting powdered snow is the only advancement that I have left. Just a lot harder to get than I thought it would be. Upgrade a 3rd blue axolotl. Look at that, perfect. We've also got to pick up the bucket and put it down again so it doesn't despawn. I think it's finally time this ladder was removed as well as these ones here. And this tank can be patched up. If I grab this ice as well, it can be put in the roof, and that is that completely done. We're going to leave the chest for now, though. I can't be bothered to pick
it up. Wow. Thorns 3. Wait, there's 2.
Not very well, apparently. Okay, never mind. There's a chest underneath. I thought I got no bamboo at all. That's good. Let me worry for a second. Look at all this sugar cane. That's pretty good. Business is finally moving. For my next project, I'm going to build a magma farm. I'm going to build this. We're going to need a lot of building blocks, a load of glass, and a load of other items. And that is nearly everything. Except I also need a couple of pumpkins. And this farm is the perfect place to get them. Apparently something's gone wrong. This minecart has got stuck, which is it's not a good thing because there's loads of shulkers up there now. Let's carve both of these. And now we need to go from the Salt Delta. And this seems like a pretty good spot to me. I'm going to place a couple of temporary blocks and a double chest just like this. Then we can get rid of those. And I can build these chests in a line with poppers on top. I think it's going to use some stone building blocks. We're going to use stone bricks and create a big platform right here. And on top of this, we're going to need loads of rails. And there we go. Next, need blocks all the way along here and all the way along here. I also want to give power to all these powered rails, and levers are perfect for that. This means that all the hopper minecarts can now be placed on top, and then I'm going to cover all of that up. But thanks to my boots, this is actually pretty quick.
Next, I'm going to cover this way faster.
Next, I shall encircle all this in glass.
Obviously, I'm not going to live in this village because that would just basically be just free enchantment books. That would be stupid.
Now this outer ring is done, I need to fill in all the inside. And there we go. That's an entire glass wall all the way around here.
But I'm not going to live in this village just because that would just be overpowered free things. So I'm not going to live in this village. But I will come back one day to get all the things that I need, like the villagers and stuff. So I'll kidnap them and become my future business partners. So this village wasn't that bad. Shut the frick up. This village wasn't that bad. Only if it had a blacksmith, it would be a little bit better. But this village wasn't even that bad, first of all. So I'll take it. The village was better than nothing.
Open,
there's a creeper. Hi, Mr. Creeper. I don't have anything to do with you. Okay. Just want to get this hard. See ya. Anything to do with you. Because I want to check out this plane's bottom because this could be. Oh, yeah. Definitely not a cave. This one's terrible. But I do see something in the distance.
Every time a new day dawns, Minecraft updates to the next version. That one instead has gone through all of alpha, all of beta, then every full release.
If I could live in a plains biome that's like right next to like a beach or something. Not like enough.
Crazy and unexpected effects on my world that I've never seen anywhere.
I hear lava.
Here we are in the brand new world. We are not even on alpha at this point. It's
So if I can find like a plains biome with like some beach right next to it, then I'll live there. But this one is not made for me, honestly. I don't want to take this plains biome. I need sugar cane, and I want to make a sugar cane farm as fast as I can. So, sugar cane farm would be very, very helpful.
There's
like a cool place for your beach sheep. Very helpful. See, now this was our. Honestly, I might go head back to spawn. Think I'm gonna head back to 0-0. Because I think over there was better. Ooh. Yeah, I might live in that forest back over there at spawn. So I'm gonna head back to spawn. I don't want to live like by the ocean because drowns can come up and scare the lifeless out of me. So drowns are nothing that you want to mess with. So I'm gonna head back to spawn where I spawn so that so I'm gonna have to get out my cords. So I moved to 200 blocks away from the spawn. Holy. So now they're both going down. Actually, I need that Z counter to go up. So I need that Z counter to go up. So I came like from the left of the village, I believe. I do not remember. But it's like a huge cave with like a monster farm. It's like a monster farm. I'm just trying to be safety right now. Safety is where I need to be. Hello, Mr. B. How are you? Good. See you around. Here's the village. I came from the birch forest. So I saw this right here from the birch forest.
Oh my goodness, I was just not paying attention there at all.
But the Z counters. Oh no, no, it's actually going on. It's time I got out of this game.
It's a new day and a brand new version. InfDev 2010.
Is there a mob spawner right below me? So I'm gonna head back to 0-0. Go ahead and go to which 00 is basically spawns. That's a real portal. Okay, I'm actually super close to 00. So. Now my character's going up. This one wasn't bad. Okay, so 00 should be this one. This way. No. Yes, the birch forest. 00 is. Yes, that one's going up. That one's going up. It's going up.
What?
Okay, it's over here. So 00 is a little bit over here.
They staircase based on the block behind them. Not confusing at all, but it looks like we've got there in the end. Let's place down some planks and glass. And apparently glass on top has turned on Mr.
Oh, see it, I see it. It's over there, it's over there.
I built more of a house when the game was updated. Also, look at iron blocks. They look so, so strange. It's not a little like that anymore. And whilst the darkness is upon me, I'm going to try more strip mining. Another day has passed. I have got plenty of cobblestone.
Honestly, I don't care where zero is. Honestly, I don't care where 00 is, because I might as well just look at this horse. Honestly, I'll take it. So, start chopping down some trees, because I'll make them useful for my house. Yeah. So right here, I don't have to landscape some of this out.
This looks kind of cool. Now, do double chests exist? Yes, they do. I give me way more space, and I can also craft brand new armor, because my old ones have broken. And now we're on the version that added snow blocks and snowballs. I'm going to run around this town no water particles. The house is now fully connected to the mountain with all the plants that I need.
And now it's time to start construction on my house.
And finish these pathways. This is so weird. You can place a block and damage yourself. You can easily place the block on the block instead. That's great. That's this shore reached. And I thought it'd be cool to do a nice little crossroads in the middle. There we go. And just because we're in Alpha doesn't mean we can't do some nice decorating. And there we go. It's the kind of thing an Alpha player would create, but you put it out. I like it. Let's have a light along the pathway. And I think this is looking very, very nice indeed. I have no idea why my house is filled with sheep and pigs. Like you, I'm going on the middle because I can eat you. Although I didn't drop any pork chops. It looked annoying. I went with Alpha version 1.2 before I add the stairs below here, because then they will be fixed. But until then, my walls will have no bottom. I'm also going to mine up some more wood to add a second layer to my house. Finally, it's getting light again. My house is full of sheep, I don't know why.
Okay, now.
We're at 1.0.11, which adds a brand new mod, which I've so far been unable to find. There it is. Cows are now in Minecraft. You can't eat them, but you can get leather from them, and you can also milk them. I don't know what the point of milk is. I can't even drink it. No idea. In fact, it seems that milk is just stuck in this bucket for life now. I can't do anything about it, can I? I can't throw it out or anything. What a great addition cows are. I'll have to wait till I update my game to see that now. But more importantly, we have got so much pork chops. They're all now cooked and ready to go. Something else very cool was added in this update. I'm going to show you quick before it gets dark. Yes, boats. The very, very slow and flimsy boats that allow me to sail across the Seven Seas. Hello, little pig. They are the most annoying thing I've ever had to try and control. Let's just very carefully park it here for now. Wait, how do I get out of a boat? Can I get some jump in there? No, just not. I'm stuck in a boat, guys! Wait, I got a break. Oh, I see. There's me trying to get out of the boat without breaking it. That's the only way to get out of it. That's the check more now.
mine, you got lots and lots more sun. Isn't they did also add the jukebox and two music discs, but to make a jukebox had need a diamond. I think it's time I went searching again and tried to find one. I found a decent cave. Let's try and finally find some diamonds. Since they found lava and a spider, it's gonna have to be a little bit careful. Surely there's gotta be diamonds around here. Yes, there is!
Honestly, I'm gonna need to start a farm like quick. So I'm gonna get to landscaping, but right now this looks pretty good. Like the outline of my house. This looks good. Okay, so I'm gonna get down chopping trees. So I'm gonna get down chopping trees. Bam. There's one tree. Birch log would be nice. Birch logs are nice. Landscaping it is. Oh, I hate landscaping. I hate landscaping, honestly, I don't like it, it's kind of boring. But, if I have to make my house look good, landscaping has to go. Was the end of day two. This is not bad. Oh my god. Okay, so this is all landscaped. So day two and day three are just going to be basically just landscaping the house. It's kind of boring, but y'all get to see more stuff like diamond mining later on in the series. See, it doesn't look bad. Honestly, like it. Would you like it to be all hilly around my house? I didn't think so. So this is what's going on right now. Honestly, I like it. Doesn't look ugly. Wait, let me see. This real fast. This too. So this one must be broken. I don't know. The three doors are going to be installed. I don't care. I'm just like that. Three doors are going to be installed. Get these flowers out of my way. Honestly, I'm going to make a chest so I can sell all my stuff. I can start like a farm. Like there's some seeds down there. That's great. Ooh, hold on, I'm gonna make some torches real fast. Break Yeah, so that I can place it around my compound. So that I won't have to worry about mobs at night. Okay, so now we are going to start a plentiful wheat farm. Plentiful wheat farm. So, make a stone hoe. Okay, so we can plentiful stone hoe. Then I'm gonna need one more piece of iron. So I'm going to go out 4 bits, which is really quick, so that I can find any type of like iron. Because I just need one piece of iron, just one. It's literally all I need. Honestly, I might just go down into my house so that I could just. Oh, I messed up. I didn't get that. Get. So look, it's the landscaping is it's gonna be better. I'm gonna take out a little bit more, so I must have to try to make it. So I need mine. And there goes a new set of shovel. Place everything that I don't need in here. That I don't need right now. Oh wait, one of my birch saplings. I need my stone shovel. Take this stick right here. And then get back to landscaping. Piece of iron for a buck. So, just need one more. I could just create like a little mine shack in my house. So. Honestly, I'm gonna put some torches in my house. So, no mobs will spawn in my house. Because I'm kind of weird. Mobs spawn in my house. So, iron spawns below sea level. So no mining below sea level.
Nice little safe house is right here. Let's go back home. And I can just do a little bit of decoration in it. With netherite like that. And I want it to kind of grow out onto these walls of the
iron is actually really plentiful in the this version of Minecraft. So I might find iron super fast. Beta 1.0.
I do hear a chicken above me somewhere.
Oh, I called it. I actually just called it. Wow, what? I just called that. I am amazing at Minecraft. I'm not. I suck at Minecraft. I'm known to die a lot in Minecraft hardcore. But I have an extra 6 pieces, so I'll make 8 pieces of iron, which will be more than I had. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and mine out this little. There's like one more slant of this place, so I'm just gonna mine out this. So this isn't going bad. I haven't died yet, so just, that's good. So I'm gonna make a plentiful wheat farm, and what I'm going to do is I'm also going to make a like, wall around my compound so that no mobs will just scare me and I'm gonna do some stuff. So I'm going to make some wheat now. So my wheat farm will be right here. Take all my iron. Grab my
goodness. That's why you don't dig down. But hey, doesn't matter what version of Opera I'm in, or Vector, or whatever. No matter what version you're in, a water bucket will always save you from lava. We have to find a little bit of a cave, and the redstone could be useful.
Make.
But ideally, more diamonds is what I want.
Pickaxe.
Some gold, which
and
is also
a sword.
Diamond, right? Really not the greatest.
May not be a lot,
this,
but
on the other
that's
hand,
what I got.
Looks a little,
that's what I
a
got.
Little more promising. I was going to say it's a little bit more promising when looking at this. Beautiful.
Okay, so an iron pickaxe could be really, really helpful.
Five
so
I'm going to
mine this a little bit of this place out, and then place some water. Just mine up this coal
more
fast.
So now I'm just going to dig my way out. Would you look at this? I found sugarcane. Although in this version, it is still known as reeds. It can't craft sugar, but it can craft paper. Now we're in Beethoven 1.2, which has added a brand new mod. Minecraft is slowly starting to look more and more like the game is today.
So we're going to go down here, grab a bucket of water.
Okay,
now, I'm going to get a little principle right here. Get some more water. Move around. Back to my compound. This is turning out to be the great hardcore series right now. So on day 5, right now it is currently day 3. But on day 5, I'm going to end the episode. Well, yeah. End the episode of Hardcore Minecraft Episode 1. Seeds. Bam, bam. Seedy place. A seedy place. Even though I already have bread. So, I'm gonna say I should have crafted a shield. But, going back down into my mine shaft. Go ahead and mine. Go down for some more iron. So I can sleep so that these days can go faster. Honestly, I'm not doing that bad so far. I have iron tools. So day 3 is coming to an end, and day 4 is coming out. Oh, and I glitched through the wall again. Yeah. So look at that. Those seeds are growing. Actually, right now, I'm going to go get some more seeds. So, oh, and there goes one. I'm just going to get 3 more. So I'm going to have 4 seeds. So there's 2. And 2 more.
This is quite a special update because it has added walls. There is also cookies now, but they're quite hard to get, so we'll hope we'll ignore those. Right now, I have just 2 tests.
There's another one.
It's probably the wrong time of day for that. So instead, I'm going to try and track down the wolf. Hang on a minute. Do you remember what that giant pole was there for? I put it there because it leads straight to your dungeon.
Boom. So now it is currently day 3 as I'm recording this. So for the people that are watching when I probably survived for about 1,000 days, probably, I said probably, keyword notice how I said probably, when, if I ever do survive for 1,000 days, then you will see then that I, when I'm recording this, I am on day 3 right now, I think, not 4. Yeah, so it is just basically just all landscaping. These first few days are just all landscaping. Just these few days are going to be landscaping. Just because I don't want to start on anything real too quick. Because how I die is I tend to go in caves and I just don't think of anything smart. I just die. So I'm not gonna be super jump in and like be like, okay guys, we're gonna head into this cave. Yeah, I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna be super duper smart. So, yeah, I won't have to die within the first few days of my hardcore world. Because this could be a very, 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 very plentiful hardcore world. Place these seeds. Boom, go. Now we have a whole row of seeds. So, now we're gonna go mining. Oh wait, I have 20 pieces of iron. Okay, so I'm gonna do it. Pieces of cobblestone walls, so my house slash compound will be safe to go through. I'm also, once it hits the end of day 5, I will go ahead and go get some sugar cane so that I can make a sugar cane farm, a plentiful sugar cane farm, so that, that's all I could do for the wall right now. But right now, I will go get some sand so I can make a sugar cane farm. So. Okay, I hear lava. I don't want to be too scared. I don't want to die to this lava. I messed up again. I hear zombies. That should be enough. Bucket of water. Hello. Thank you. Bucket of water. Head back to my compound so I can place this bucket of water. I'll make my sugarcane farm right over here. Get over here, it's just gonna keep me still. I want it to keep you still every single way of the water. So I'm gonna go ahead and place that. So now it'll keep me straight. I'll show you right now. There we go. It won't move me, so it'll be fine. I will build a bigger farm in the future, so I can place my sugar cane inside of the house. There. In the farm. So that's all the time that I had for the sugarcane farm. So. But I still have time in the day, so might as well just go mining. So we're gonna go down here. my level 11 head for diamonds. Level 30 right now.
Unfortunately, it's a bit of a challenge to get across to it. I'll have to go around the long way. I've successfully made it in, and at this point, there are no chests anywhere. But what there is, well, there's blanks, and I better just not try and set myself on fire. They're also so much easier to deal with because you can spam click. Probably a good idea to grab some nether wart whilst I'm here. And this as well. That way I can grow my own from home. I've found the outside part of the stronghold, so the spawners can't be far. Is this risky? Yeah, maybe a little bit. But I found the throne room. I found two throne rooms.
Surface. My C counter just went up, like high up. So that means there's like a cave somewhere. So there's a cave over here. I'm not going to the cave. My C counter is just not going down. So there's just like a huge cave right here. Oh yeah, my C counter, it's here. If you guys want to know where my C counter is, it's up here. So my C counter is huge right here. So, oh, it's like, alright, so day 5. Since the beginning of day 5. So I got a bunch of stuff. Oh no, there's a baby zombie. I should make a shield. That is so scary. I should light up the place. That's scary. Oh my god, I thought it was a loser right there. That is when you want to torch up the place. Oh my god. Bones? I'm gonna need 11 more pieces of iron, so I need 9 more pieces, I think. think.
I'm watching it. I'm coming along. I don't know how I didn't see them. Now, then, how many have we got here? There's always a few. This little pocket of cave that I've stripped mine to has turned out to be very, very useful. Oh, okay. Don't burn. Don't let them burn now, it's me. None of this crucial thing. Look at that. Hey, I was careful there. You know what? These diamonds aren't getting mine just yet. Let's check that all sides are safe. Yeah, I see you. I think we're good now. We don't lose any diamonds at all. Now, with my 8 diamonds, let's get out of here. It was a pretty successful mining mission. 1.2.5. Oh my gosh, that's a jungle. I'm just gonna say 1.2.5 improves ocelots, and you can shift the items out of the furnace.
Oh, that's sounds meta.
I make a fishing rod and start collecting up a bunch of fish. I was completely forgotten this is how fish used to live. 11 fish should be enough. Now let's try and find an ocelot. We've got one here. Is that a baby? There's two of them. And this is an adult. Okay. Come on, little kitty cat. You know. Yes, we got one. You come with me. The old one fish wonder returns. We also get some pork on the way. I've also realised something that's put all the other plans out the window. They removed the ability to get ice with Silk Touch for a bunch of versions. I've been doing the research, and it was only possible to get ice with Silk Touch in a single snapshot, but that is not possible now. They removed it because of the water in the netherbook. So when I upgrade to 1.3.1, I'll be able to collect ice, but it won't melt to become water in the nether. Welcome to your new home, little kitty cat. I think I'm going to call you Smudge, and now I'm going to get some sleep. And version 1.3.1 has so many features. These include adding emeralds and trading. There's also jungle and desert pyramids. And one of my favourite features ever, nut chapels. I'm just here to quickly grab glowstone. Oh, this is beautiful with efficiency. I wish it was still like that in the newer versions. I can grab 4 pieces. Let's place these all around the egg. There we go. Now that I can get nut chapels, I guess I'm going to have to see if I can make a gold farm. So to build a gold farm, I'm going to be going above the bedrock. So that means I'm going to need to go out in search of obsidian and enderpearls. Whilst not chapels are craftable, I really want to be taken advantage of.
Oh, that's a mystery.
There's also lava at this desert, which will also be a great way for you to find endermen. Here is the lava.
Let me help.
Yes.
Excuse me, sir. Would you like your buns toasted?
No pearl from him.
Or do you want them just soft
right here,
or crispy?
Which again didn't get a pearl. And my health is looking very, very bad now.
Like toasted. You want to toast
it? I'll take a toast.
Turn this lava to be obsidian and get busy mining it up. I have to say, mining with efficiency is so much better.
So
these pieces should be enough. I'm just going to wait till it's daytime.
Oh, that's more redstone.
Bring a bed. The next day has now begun. This is very carefully swooping across here. I desperately need food, so I think I'll go fishing. And whilst I'm doing the fishing, I can be cooking the fish.
See, 5 down.
This
time
is
one
little bit better.
Oh,
I'm
at 1 level 9,
down
that's not
to good. Cook lots more food than I have been collecting.
And level
back to the end. Okay,
yeah.
Just meal just the end. Platform with a little difference in off that. Well, the good news is the end is still looking exactly the same. Now let's anger loads of endermen. Come on, guys, you know you want me. Apparently they just do not care. You really? Okay, well, I've got it. I think I'm just going to go around smacking it. It's just easier. There we go, we got a pearl. And another one, and that's pearl number 3. And now I've got 8, I think I should have enough. I was going to say that 1.3.2 basically added nothing. It just made large oak trees have logs that are sideways.
Is mine piece of iron?
Oh,
my sea counter.
It's a load of bug fixes.
So it's out of 4 right now. My sea counter's out of 4.
1.4.2 added withers, beacons, warheads, handfuls, potatoes, carrots.
Sea counter's at a 2.
I've got this bats, iron frame, swamp hoods, night vision, visibility, and we got looting too. Okay, that is such a good sword.
Oh, my sea counter's at a 97 over here.
Just
6 though. 99 over here.
Hold on a second. I can do something like this and create an anvil. Now, will it be expensive? Oh my goodness, it's very expensive. I'm glad they made it so anvils aren't that ridiculous in newer versions. Definitely not worth it.
Okay, my
sea counter
just went down.
We go after the winner.
So I'm not going to worry about that
right now. It might take a while, we've got looting too now, so I shall attempt to head back towards the fortress.
So I'm not going to worry about that right
now. Let's start collecting the items for the wither. I've taken a lot of withers, but we still haven't got any heads. And now we're on version 1.14.4. The best thing this has added is that water now stops all fall damage. But MLGs are now a thing. And that is head number 1 achieved. In 1.4.5, things bug fixes. Which makes me question, why am I now stuck in the floor?
How much redstone have I found? I found over a stack.
Bombs, and using books to upgrade items on an anvil. An upgrade to this version has also made my sound stop. I don't know why. Hopefully it's fixed in the next update. Oh, look at that. We got it. I hope I don't die now just before this crucial time. 1.5. Okay, that's good. I may not be able to hear anything, but that's not going to stop me from getting out of here. Here we are, home sweet home. And it's snowing. Lovely. It never used to be able to snow on the ice, did it? Since the ice age happened, this is what we're living with. Now, do I battle the wither like this? Is it a risk? Realistically, it's probably quite a big risk. But then again, taking risks is my speciality. So I'm going to get a bunch of arrows and then go for it. Now, apparently MLGs work, so let's test it out.
If I'm gonna mine 30,000 blocks towards the border before I even find a single piece of diamonds, and I found more iron, I'll take it.
I'm not too confident I'll find any, but before I get head home, I'm just gonna try and find some diamonds. My arm is nearly broken, I can repair it with these 6 diamonds, but being able to make other pieces would also be nice. I'm now at the level where diamonds can be found, and you know, since lapis has been added and I'm gonna need it in a few updates, it was worth mining up. And we have found at least one, and if we found more than one, oh, that's good.
Ooh, I didn't see this. And here goes my pickaxe. 19 pieces of iron, I'll take. And it's night time.
In this video, I will get every advancement in hardcore Minecraft within 100 days. Trust me, I will not mess this up. Hardcore Minecraft is a pretty difficult
and we are
game.
On
I mean,
now
it's the most
day
difficult
6.
Mode you can play in vanilla.
So.
Mobs spawn more often, they do more damage to you, and then if you happen to die, you can't respawn.
Now,
I am
going to smell my iron at the end of this episode so that I can now go ahead and make myself some armor. And first, let's try to get an apple so that I can make an enchanted or not enchanted golden apple. Just a little quick apple. Quick apple search. Oh, I got an apple. Cool.
As soon as I click this button, I guess it's time to get serious. On day one, I spawn in with one goal in mind. Kill the dragon as soon as possible. I quickly
oh,
check
an
the
enemy.
Skills around me at spawn, and I see that I have a village and an ocean, which is going to be great for future advancements. I immediately get to crafting my basic tools and killing some cows and sheep. I gather some more food from the village, and go ahead and knock out the advancement for trading with a villager. One advancement down, just like that. I'm not even going to take this leather.
I can't cure him right now. That makes me mad. I can't cure him. That's upsetting.
Mining in an underwater cave by using doors as air pockets. But I forgot what it's like to play without Aqua Affinity, Respiration, and Death Strider. And I give up on it only after smelting 7 iron ingots. Luckily for me, though, I find a shipwreck.
Golden apple.
I get some more iron.
I like this.
And immediately start heading for it. However, with night still upon me and only a chest plate crafted so far, I didn't feel comfortable getting on land to dig for it yet. So I continued scouting out the ocean and came across a second shipwreck.
Two creepers. Okay.
That's what we wanted to see.
Oh my god. That's so scary. I hate it when creepers do that.
I went to sleep to knock out sweet dreams. That's a solid first day right there. On day two, I find my treasure. I get some gold ingots, my first diamond, and for some reason, I don't take the Heart of the Sea. But I do take the water breathing potions. I don't really know what I was thinking. I noticed that I had seeds in my inventory and decided to knock out a seedy plant before dropping them. Right after this, I find a lava pool. So I craft up my gold boots, build my portal, and immediately enter the nether.
And
put me anywhere from the
full
center.
Iron armor. So
I
like you got.
Okay. I got a safe spawn.
First.
And it got even better when I traveled only 100.
How'd you get in?
Spawned a bastion. And I knew that I had to head straight for it.
It's useless. So, before I end this video, I'm going to go ahead and place all these torches around so that I can go ahead.
For stepping inside, but I was terrified that I'd run into a piglet brute. And this gas only decided to make it worse, but I got an amazing shot off on it.
So there we go, we lit up the place.
I was struggling to figure out what type of bastion this was.
We lit up the place, and now we're going
to
make a little quick
fast. I found my first piglet brute. Luckily, he can't get to me, and I was able to take him out with a lava bucket. And right next to him was a chest. I get the war pigs advancement and a load
think it was this.
Right after crossing
yep.
into day three, I noticed that there's a front section of this bastion that digs into the basalt delta next to it, and I realized,
boom.
Looking
there
at the ridge bastion, probably the best kind for this challenge. It has the most gold blocks, and even better, this one was completely enclosed. So I sealed the bridge off and was safely able to mine.
Okay,
it
guys, well, that
and
will be the end of today's Hardcore Minecraft Series Episode 1. There's a creeper.
I got into a fight with one hoblin,
okay,
then
I
a second,
cannot.
And then I made it back to my portal and left another. I just needed a breather.
Okay.
By the time I made it to the overworld, the sun had already set. I spent the rest of night 3 scouting more of my area around me and found a shipwreck with one soul on board. Well, it wasn't affected much, that's for sure. When the sun came up on day 4, I was ready to go back in the nether and find my fortress. Considering I didn't see any en route to the bastion, I knew it was going to have to be in the opposite direction from my portal.
Oh, I got him.
I
actually just got him. Okay, guys, well, that will be the end of today's episode. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.